Good morning, dear students. I am Vinadas Srivastava, and today, as on online classes, we are just going to study about the first chapter of biology of class 6. The topic is plant life. So, when we are just going for the plant is divided mainly into two parts. The first part, that is under the soil, that particular part is called root system. It absorbs water and mineral for the plant. And the second part, that is above the soil, that is known as shoot system. It mainly consists of leaf, flower, fruit and all other parts, those are present above the soil. Next, when we are just going for the main part of the plant, that is the shoot system, it consists of leaves. Leaves are green in color due to presence of chlorophyll, and they process food for plant. And due to that, while they are just processing the food, they are known as the kitchen of the plant. When we are just going for the structure of leaf, then the structure of leaf, the main part of the leaf is its leaf plate. That particular leaf plate is also called as lamina. And the second part that is associated with the lamina is called midrib. Midrib is the main vein of the leaf. And the third part that is related with the midrib and attached with the branch is petiole. It is the stalk of the leaf. When we are just going for the structure of leaf, you can just see all the parts over here. And midrib is finally divided into small veins. And secondly, when we are just going on the types of leaf on the basis of lamella, the lamella is on the basis of lamella, the leaf is of two type. First, the leaf is simple leaf when the lamella is not divided, like the mango leaf. You can just see the mango leaf, guava leaf, those leaves are undivided lamella. And the secondary leaf, that is the compound leaf, in that particular leaf, the lamella or the leaf blade is divided into several parts on the midrib. And the main function of the leaf is to provide gases exchange, photosynthesis, and to remove the excess amount of water. Some plants are reproductive pattern having vegetative propagation. It is a particular pattern of reproduction in which the plant have fleshy and juicy leaves in which they bear buds on their edge. And when these leaves fall down on the ground, these buds grow into the form of new plants. Now we are just going on the flower. You all have just seen the flower in different colors, many color, red, orange, yellow, green. So when we are just going for the flower, the colorful part of the petal, the colorful part of the flower is called petal, and it is supported by the sepal. That particular sepal connected with the branch, and these particular parts are the responsible platform for the fertilization and the pollination. Now, when we are just going for this particular part that is called pistil. Pistil is the female reproductive part of flower, and it consists of stigma, style, and ovary. You can just see over here that particular part, the top of the part is stigma, where a thin part is connected up to the ovary. That particular thin part is called pollen tube. That pollen tube, it carries the pollen grains. And now we are just going for the stamen. Like pistil, the pistil is the female reproductive part, and the stamen, that is the male reproductive part, that consists of anther and filament. Anther consists pollen grains. Pollen grains are the male gamete for the reproduction. Now when the pollen grains are transferred to stigma, here we can just see the anther, and here it is the pollen grains. These pollen grains, those are present in anther, are transferred to stigma. From there, they are just transferred to the pollen tube. So when we are just going for the pollination, it means the transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma. And when we are just going for the pollination, it is of two type. First, self-pollination. In self-pollination, the flowers of the same plant pollinated with each other. It means the pollen grains of one flower of same plant or the other flower of the same plant is transferred to the same flower or the other flower of same plant. It means self-pollination takes place in same plant. But the cross-pollination, the second one, in this particular type of pollination, the pollen grains are transferred from the anther to stigma of one flower of one plant to another flower of another plant. Now, here you can just see, this is the one plant, and here the pollen grains are transferred. This type of pollination is self-pollination. But when the pollen grains are transferred to the another plant, then this is the cross-pollination. We have some agents, because the pollen grains are not directly going towards the flower. So we have some agents, those carries pollen grains, like air, water, insect and animal. Now, when the pollen grains reaches to stigma, these pollen grains are transferred to the ovary by the pollen tube, and there they fuse with ovule. So pollen grains are male gametes and ovules are female gametes, and these male gametes are transferred to female gamete by the pollen tube, and there they fuses with female gamete. So when we are just going for the fertilization, fertilization is the process where male gamete and female gamete fuses with each other, and the fusion of male and female gamete forms zygote, that is converted again into embryo. Now, formation of fruit and seed. Earlier we have just talked about ovary. When the ovary is fertilized, it means the male and female gamete are fused, then it is converted into fruit. And the ovules, those are present inside the ovary, those are just converted into seed. After fertilization, ripened ovary is converted into fruit. It can be fleshy or dry. Now we are just going for the part of the fruit. There are mainly three parts. First is epicarp, second is meso, and the third is endo. It should be very clear. When we are just going for the epi, this is the outer. Meso means middle, endo means innermost. Epicarp is the outer layer of the fruit. Mesocarp, the middle or the fleshy layer of the fruit, and endocarp is the innermost layer of the fruit that enclose the seed. Here you can just see the diagram of the fruit. When we are just going for the seed, seed is also of two type. You can just see over here. Here you can just see there are two pattern of seeds, two types of seed. First type of seed is dicot, and the second one is monocot. Dicot means the seed containing two cotyledons, and monocot means the seed containing one cotyledon. See, all the seeds contain one plumule, one radicle, and the cotyledon, it can be one or two. So it should be clear the structure of seed. When we are just going for the cotyledon, it contains reserve food material for the baby plant, until unless the baby plant can not produce its food, the cotyledon provide food to baby plant. The radicle are converted into roots, and the plumules are converted into shoots. So these particular pattern, it should be very clear. The number of cotyledon divides the seed into two types. First one is dicot, and the second one is monocot. Now the seed, it is fertilized ovule, as we have just discussed it earlier. The ovary is fertilized, it forms fruit, and the ovules, those are fertilized, those are formed seeds. It consists of an embryo, one or two collinear and covering of this seed is called seed coat. Embryo bears radical that I have just told you earlier, and it develops into root, and the seed is germinated. When we sow the seed in the ground or the soil, the seed is grow into new baby plant. That particular pattern is known as seed germination. The seed germination need air, water, and a particular temperature, and these baby plant are known as seedling or sapling. So first pair of leaf of plant is called cotyledon. So cotyledon are also providing the food to baby plant, and they are also the reserve food material for baby plant. So I think this particular chapter will be clear to you, and thank you.